Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Mary. In this video today, I'm going to talk about all of the products that I regret buying. There are some of these products which I forgot to mention in my previous I regret buying video, and there are some products which I tried after that video, so I'm going to include all of those things in this video today. So please continue watching. First product that I regret buying is this Pond's Light Moisturizer. I have reviewed this product, and in the review I did give it a good review, saying that this worked for me and it's a good moisturizer. So I tested it for 1 week, and after 1 week I made the review, and then immediately after a few days, I think it was almost 2 weeks, when it started giving me a reaction around my mouth area. I started getting a lot of acne breakouts, and that is when I was not using anything new, and it's just this moisturizer that I was using. So definitely there was a delayed reaction on my skin. This is very heavy on the fragrance. If you check the ingredient list, perfume in this moisturizer, it's very high. That is something that does not work for me when it comes to leave-on skincare products. This is why I regret buying this moisturizer, but I'm happy I got the smallest pack, because they have bigger tubs as well. I would have deeply regretted if I would have got that huge tub. So anyways, this was the first product. Second product that I regret buying is this Moha Herbal Face Wash. Usually face wash is something that works even if it contains artificial fragrance in it, but there is just something that did not work for me. When I used this face wash, it made my skin very dry, even though it says on the packaging that it cleanses, moisturizes and protects your complexion. Well, moisturizing is something that this face wash does not do. It's very drying on the skin. My skin is oily, still it managed to dry out my skin, so I don't think so this would be great for dry skin. Says it's herbal, there are a lot of natural herbal ingredients in it. Okay, so I was trying to find out what exactly did not work for me. I went through the ingredient list. There was this ingredient called Rosa centifolia. Now this is like a cabbage rose, but they have not mentioned what exactly is used, like the rose extract, rose seed oil, what part of the rose is used, that is not mentioned. So I assume that it might be like a fragrant aspect that was derived from the rose and you put in the face wash, because it's very heavy on the fragrance. So maybe that is one thing that did not work for me. Apart from the drying aspect, when I was using this face wash, it was giving me burning sensation during the time of using it. So it was something that was like, scary. It was something that was problematic. I thought something is wrong and I had to stop using it. I tried it, I think, only 3 times, and every single time I got that burning feeling while using the face wash, and it's very drying face wash too. So that is why I regret buying this. Third product that I regret buying is, this was very disappointing for me, because I just went by the name of the brand and I purchased this. So the third product that I regret buying is the Pears shower gel or body wash. Now I thought the soap bar might be good, so maybe they make good shower gels too. So I purchased it, and I have used sulfate based shower gels, and there are some that works for me, but when I used this shower gel, it was so drying. After 3-4 uses, it just started peeling off the skin, and my skin started becoming so dry and flaky, and it was like completely red. And my skin is oily, and I was using it during the summer. Another thing I do not like is that they say that this has 98% glycerin on the front side of their bottle. If you turn the bottle and look at the ingredient list, glycerin ingredient comes after fragrance and perfume, which means perfume is much more higher than glycerin. So perfume is more than 98% in this body wash. I don't know, that is how it appears to be, but this is just something which is a very bad formula, and this is something I regretted the most. fourth product that I regret buying is the Nivea Micellar Water. I think this was launched a year back, and when it was launched, that is when I purchased it because I wanted to try something which is cheaper than simple micellar water. It was just it just did not work for me. It was not so effective at getting rid of the makeup. You have to like rub it quite a lot to remove even the non-waterproof makeup. Other thing is, every time I used it on my face, it was like giving me little bit of burning sensation every single time I used it. So somehow it was irritating my skin. I stopped using it because the formula just did not work for me, and then I thought I should go for something which is designed for sensitive skin, and then I went for the simple micellar water, which works great for my skin. But this is just that something that did not work for me. I had seen a lot of good reviews, so maybe it does work for some people. Last product that I regret buying is this Thwak Coffee Bean and Ginger Hair Shampoo. This shampoo was a little bit drying for my hair. It has a good fragrance. It was a little bit drying. It did not work for me, and then I also experienced a little bit of extra hair fall. Some products, they just, my hair does not like. I have to be very selective when it comes to hair care products, and there's a lot of things that do not work for my hair. So this is one thing that did not work for me. It might be a good shampoo, ingredient list, they look okay to me. So yeah, I regret buying as it did not work for my hair. So these were some of the products that I regretted buying this year. There are some products which I mentioned in my previous video. You can check that out from the description box below. I make a lot of skincare and makeup related videos. The playlist will be mentioned in the description. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel for more such videos. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.